said good day, sir!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the defense. My name is Epi, and we have four friends and Krilly going up against Pain Gaming. So, a Brazilian team up against, I'm not even sure where four friends and Krilly are for, but for that I do have a co-caster. And it is none other than Ham Sandwich, the guy that you might know from as a co-caster from Toby, but he's not in Malaysia with Toby at the moment. I think it's Malaysia, isn't it? Ham, are you there?
Yes, I actually am here. 4SC is from Sweden. I think Toby is in Malaysia. SMM is what he's at, which is Malaysia, I'm pretty sure.
I think it should, at any rate. And this is also the reason why we are doing the defense for him. Of course, the defense is sponsored by Rocket, as well as Own3D TV. So thanks to those two companies, as well as you guys for tuning in. Highly appreciated. And I do look forward to some top-notch Doto so far. How have you been, Ham?
I've been okay. There's a little bit of construction in my building at this point, just outside. And even with the window closed, you can still hear some hammering and some drilling from time to time. So hopefully that isn't too big of a distraction for people.
Yeah, I hope so as well. Alternatively, you can just open the window, yell at them, and be like, guys, there's a Dota match going on. Show some respect, and then they will be like, oh, sorry, I'm sorry, and then they'll stop.
I think they're just mad because they're at work and they can't be at home watching it.
I know that feeling, man. I know that feel. I know that feel only too well. But I mean, now I'm done with work, so now I can actually commit myself to some good old Dota. And if I look at this draft, it doesn't seem all too much out of the ordinary. The Batrider gets taken out. Pain Gaming, as well as Four Friends and Krilly, I don't know all too much about them. I've cast them a few times already, but not nearly as often enough as to so that I'm able to kind of talk about the team and their like preferred strats and such, so we'll probably just have to see how the drafts unfold. But so far it's looking pretty standard. We of course still have Sven in the pool. We might see a Darkseer pick up or a Jakiro or something like that, and then we will go from there.
Yeah, I know that I've seen Pain play, and they had a really, really strong run through the open qualifier. They played really well, got themselves into the tournament. And they showed a relatively strong game against Empire. They lost, but I think that they played well as a team. They sort of fell a little bit behind in farm, and it snowballed from there. But as far as their team fights and clashes went, they were on par with Empire. Again, maybe just a little bit behind. So I think they'll be a good match for Friends and Krilly. But it's sort of hard to say with only three picks being made.
Yeah, I my girlfriend just told me that Four Friends and Krilly played at DreamHack as well, and to be honest, man, there's a bunch of teams that are like in the how to call it, like the midfield, I guess, of the Dota scene. That and most of them are actually really impressive in terms of their performance. As you said, Pain Gaming, as you just told the viewers as well, were up against Empire and showed some strong performances. 3D Max, another team that comes to mind, they actually beat Team Empire, showed a strong performance against Na'Vi, but in the end, they just really got outplayed by the fast-paced game that Na'Vi forced upon them. So this is, you know, when I talk about this type of stuff and consider these teams, it makes me think about the fact that the $1 million tournament that Valve does, which is the international, it kind of brings this structure into the year of Dota 2. You know, right after the international 2, you have a bunch of disbands. If sponsors kind of losing faith in their teams and saying, okay, this might not be worthwhile. And then now we're a few months, almost half a year after the international 2, and you see all these other little organizations, these really promising teams coming up. And you know, give it another 4 months or so, these teams will be another few teams that will crystallize out on the very top and show that they have the skill that it takes. And then perhaps we will see some of these teams we're casting today in the defense season 3 maybe compete at the international. Who knows?
I've just been told that you can actually not be heard in Dota TV. I think the stream's still fine, but Dota TV, there might be a little bit of an issue.
Oh, perfect. Thank you very much, man. This is my little pet peeve and the pet peeve of other people. I forget this type of stuff. Now my in-game mic's on. Thanks for pointing that out. Who told you that? Let's give him a quick shout-out.
That is Nincompoop, our one and only defense admin. Well, I guess not only, but one of our defense admins.
Yes, thank you, Nincompoop with the weird name. But yeah, now it's on. So to all you people watching over Dota 2 TV, hi, I am here, and you can hear me now as well. So there you go.
Now we can have two-sided conversations rather than one-sided conversations.
Yeah, you're crazy, man. Your name is Ham Sandwich. What do you expect? You come in and you just start talking to yourself.
Yeah, and I start by saying thanks for having me here, right?
Yeah. Thanks for having me, Dota. Thanks for letting me cast you. Nyx Assassin came out, and who was it? I think it was AUI or Eternal Envy that was like, dude, Nyx Assassin going to blow up in the comp scene, dude. It's going to be insane, going to get picked up all over the place. And now I see him in the first pick phase, picked up by Pain Gaming. So what's your opinion of him? I think the arguments I heard for him are pretty sound, I guess.
Yeah, I think he's really, really good as a hero against intelligence heroes, especially because of that meta. I mean, he's got enough control. He's got a good at sort of initiation in terms of invis and stun, good crowd control. I mean, he's an overall okay hero, but he performs really, really well in the current game because there's a lot of burst damage focused all in one area very fast, and his spike carapace does a really good job of sort of countering that or reflecting some of it back. And the fact that there are a lot of intelligence heroes being used, or mana-intensive heroes even being used, just to set up all these things, the mana burn is just that much stronger because it's based on intelligence. It's not static.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, Darkseer, for example, he's got an insane intelligence gain and base intelligence as well, so the mana burn really works well against him. And I think the Spike Carapace also makes... That's the key factor that makes him such a tough target to gank. It's just a blessing to have for whoever's on that Nyx Assassin. And we will see how he will pay off for Pain Gaming. Of course, with his Vendetta, it kind of works similarly to... Of course, it's very similar to Bounty Hunter's Windwalk, only it kicks more ass. But it's just as susceptible to these anticipatory sentry wards. And we've seen these over and over again when supports just keep their eye on the minimap and just, you know, just are able to put themselves into the shoes of the Bounty Hunter and then put down a sentry ward when they think he should be around. And more often than not, these sentries spot out the Bounty Hunters. I've seen it time and time again in the past few weeks that Bounty Hunters... are having more of a tough time as, you know, the way the game is played adapts over time, and now teams are more and more getting used to invis heroes, or even more than they used to be. And another thing that that's coming to mind now that we see Sven getting banned out in the second ban phase is how dependent he is on heroes such as Batrider or Magnus also being in the pool. You know, we can see Magnus and Batrider got banned out first, and Sven didn't get picked by either team. So I think he's pretty dependent on these heavy disables as well, especially the reverse polarity, I guess, works wonders with him. And more often than not in the past few days, we've seen Sven actually almost... always ignored in the first pick phase.
I feel like Sven is sort of was the flavor of the month and is now sort of dropping off in terms of popularity, partly because teams have found a way to deal with him. I mean, it's a lot easier. You just ban out those big disables and then you can run away from Sven. I mean, Sven needs to be beside you to hit you, so you just deny him that and you've sort of done all you can against him and he's become a useless hero.
Yeah, and okay, so Nick, let's actually go over the picks really quickly. Pain Gaming so far, TA, Nyx Assassin, Rubick, Enigma. So in general, squishy heroes a bit, you know, and powerful spells on the side as well. Of course, TA, the snowball hero, Nyx Assassin, kind of the ace up their sleeve so far. We haven't seen, well, at least I personally haven't seen Nyx Assassin that much in the competitive scene as of late, but I heard that the Chinese love him. So usually
usually
like the Chinese tendencies swap over to Europe after a little while, and it's kind of scary, man, that the Chinese were a really huge force back in Dota 1 days, then Dota 2 came around and we had this little window of the European scene dominating the world, and now it's back to normal.
Well, some of the Dota scene that I really, really like is that China and Europe don't meet very often. I mean, every once in a while you have a game or two played between Chinese teams and European teams, but for the most part, they only meet at these big events. So, for example, WCG, we saw some European teams meet Chinese teams. Chinese teams proved that they were stronger and totally swept the tournament, taking, I think, two of the top three spots, and the third spot went to Devil Mice, I think. But that just shows that China was ahead in that situation. If you look at these events, it's the only time that they actually meet with Europe, and that's the only proving ground. So you have these two sort of scenes that are separate. I mean, they can watch each other, but they never get a chance to play each other until these big events.
Yeah, absolutely, man. And I agree. And so far, when they met, I mean, the Chinese just show how it's done. They just have so much discipline when it comes to the practice, and it just shows in these competitions that the way that they move across the map is just really beautiful to watch. And of course, they deserve to be at the top so far. But I'm very, I mean, it's not like the European scene doesn't have any very powerful teams as well. But let's look at the WTF picks Kunkka as well as Anti-Mage now. I mean, is this update already in? You know, you can't crit when you hit out of Lothar's Edge. No, a Shadow Blade. Is it already in the productive environment? Do you know?
I don't think so, actually. I think that's in Dota 2 test only and will be added later tonight.
Okay, well, there you go, guys. Kunkka picked up by 4FC, so their lineup, actually, let's go over them right now. We start off with 4FC, they're heading down toward the bottom lane. 4FC, Krilly, he is playing a Lone Druid. Then we got Nose on the Darkseer. Miley Strangby playing Kunkka. This name's going to be a B to pronounce. Humps on Jakiro, and Eres Loco on Shadow Demon. What a name. Over toward Pain Side, the Brazilians, we got King RD playing TA. Then we have the Nyx Assassin being played by GrantXD. China is playing Enigma. We have Fuga on Animage, and then Pada playing the Rubik. So we might actually see a little clash. We've got 4FC running into the Radiant Jungle at the moment. The pings are going out, and they are not stopping. They are looking for the big fight. They have the good combination of the disruption into the torrent. So this is the range out of which Pain need to stay out of. And yeah, TA is backing out, and it appears that there will not be any type of fighting. The Ice Path might have been able to catch him just on the back foot, but 4FC in the end now backing off, and that is it for now.
Yeah, that's one of the problems you get sometimes when you're leading the charge with Jakiro Shadow Demon, is they're not the fastest moving heroes on the map, with 295 and 290 respectively.
Mm-hmm. Let's have a look at the lanes. It appears that we will have actually a defensive trial lane on bottom. Nyx Assassin, Rubik, and Anti-Mage. With the mid lane, of course, we'll have TA. She's now blocking as the creeps spawn. Long lane solo Enigma. Haven't seen that in a while. And an offensive trial lane by 4FC consisting of Shadow Demon, Kunkka, and Jakiro. And I must say, I got my money on this trial lane setup on the Direcide's trial lane. It's looking pretty scary. And then, of course, it leaves a Lone Druid on top.
One of the advantages that Radiant has in this trial lane is the Nyx Assassin, once he picks up 1 point in Spark Carapace, basically that's a free stun on Jakiro, because Jakiro's stuff is all AoE and in a big line, so all that Nyx Assassin needs to do is purposefully walk into it with Spike Carapace on, and that's a free stun and damage reflect on the Jakiro.
Yeah, actually that's a pretty good point, and I'm looking forward to see how the Nyx Assassin works out in action in this particular matchup here. We're already seeing the pulling happening. It's interestingly enough a single pull though, so I wonder what their intentions might be. Usually we see the stack, it's better for their experience gain, and usually when you do a single pull you intend to push, but I don't know, man.
Single pulls aren't terrible against a tri-lane, because you know that your opponents are going to kill creeps relatively quickly.
Oh, there was the disruption on bottom lane. The torrent follows up, it does hit on Nyx Assassin, Ice Path to fall through as well, but that one misses. He turns around, goes for the stun, we need a few right clicks onto him, and this might actually be enough for the first blood. No, good usage of the self, Nyx gets away for now. But they're actually still chasing. One more second for the Ice Path. Torrent gonna miss Ice Path now coming through, and that will probably be enough to kill Nyx Assassin. First blood goes to Jakiro. And they had to work hard for that one, man.
You know, well worth it, though. This tri-lane really does need to get kills in order to stay in contention with this Animage. Because in a tri-lane versus tri-lane situation, the inherent advantage, if it's sort of stagnant and nothing's happening, is to the team with the tower close by. But because 4FC is able to get a kill, or if they're able to get a kill or even two, three into this game, their tri-lane's going to be victorious. And they have the setup to do that. They have good disable in Jakiro, and obviously the Shadow Demon Kanka combo.
Yeah, absolutely. And the only thing that 4FC really needs to watch out for is there anyone out of position? Do we have one of the three heroes from Pain on bottom kind of too far away from the rest of his lane mates? And if that's true, then, or if the answer to that is yes, then Shadow Demon can look for the disruption immediately, because they can just go for the kill right then and there. It's just such a good setup for the Torrent and the Ice Path. It's just a really strong synergy between these three heroes here. Makes for some very strong laning. And then you, of course, have the benefit of having that Lone Druid on the safe lane. And he is now 10-4. Enigma sitting at 7-11.
Enigma's actually really, really strong against Lone Druid, because he gets that extra bonus damage from the Eidolons onto the Spirit Bear. So he doesn't have to run away like some other heroes do. Or at least not nearly as much.
Mm-hmm. Nyx Assassin will use the last Sentry Ward to try and deward, but it's just out of range. The ward is sitting right here, and this will just continue blocking the spawn. At least one more. Okay, so let's have a look at mid lane. Of course, it's Darkseer TA matchup. Darkseer with the multiple instances of damage due to his Ion Shell. Very good laner against TA. Let's have a look at the last. It's 14-6 for the TA and 17-1 on Darkseer. So mid is going well for 4FC. Boss going with 4FC. There's a Torrent, yes. Counter initiation, though, by Rubik. He tries to keep him alive for a little while. And now Anti-Mage comes through, auto-attacks the Jakiro, and that is it so far. Kunkka a little bit still in there. Good stun, Nyx Assassin, Ice Path misses, and we have Kunkka now on the run out. The Nukes goes out, and Anti-Mage might need to retreat with the Blink here. Back he goes, and both heroes really low in HP, and who came out on top of that? I'm not so sure. I think again 4FC. Man, Jakiro is still chasing. We have a block on Rubik. Auto-attacks are there, stun from Nyx a little bit too late, and now we even have Anti-Mage again on trouble. The Nuke from Jakiro, a little bit too much. One last right click, though. Use Shadow Demon now, the second one to fall, but this will also be the death of Anti-Mage. And Nyx Assassin even in trouble right now. Is there another nuke or disable or anything? Nothing is there. 2-for-1 exchange in favor of 4FC, and they get the kill on Anti-Mage, most importantly.
I find it really interesting that Anti-Mage hasn't actually taken any mana break points. Usually you see people take at least one just to get that little bit of annoyance and a little bit of extra damage in lane.
Yeah, absolutely. He put a secondary point into Blink, so he wants just to have that shorter cooldown, but as you said, the mana burn, at least one level in mana burn is important. Mana break, it's actually called. Third level I put into Blink. So, you know, you do have to scale your hero according to the way the game is developing, but I think the way you scale your hero can also affect greatly the way the game will develop in the future. So, now that he doesn't have the mana break skill, at least one level in it, it just really diminishes his effectiveness against the other heroes, especially like a Jakiro, where a few hits with the mana break can mean another Ice Path or not. So right now there's really no pressure onto 4FC in terms of their mana pools. There's Magic Sticks up. Very important.
Now 4FC is going to steal this pull, which is very smart by them. They know that Pain can't really contest it, especially with Nyx wandering around in the middle lane looking for the Darkseer kill.
Yeah, absolutely. And Darkseer just juked him around a little bit here. I'm not sure if he knew that Nyx was there, but that movement was really good for him.
Now the only issue Darkseer has right now is that he's out of mana. I mean, as long as he has enough for a surge, he should be okay. But it means he can't farm nearly as effectively. And Nyx, I think, is going to try and take this Invis rune out from under his nose.
Yeah, does get it. Darkseer right now has to decide. Does he want to stay here? Yeah, he will probably need to get himself back there. Nyx Assassin not able to get that stun in. And Darkseer will now retreat back to base, which gives TA some space to farm this up. He already has the Magic Stick up as well. But the tri lane for Pain so far, not working out too well, man. It's not working out too well, but all the better for 4FC so far. Even with the stand-in on Jakiro, it's working out greatly. But now we have Nyx down here. The ping goes out. We have Shadow Demon warding. So if they rotate right now, they could make something out of this. But I think by now it's already too late. Both heroes as well on bottom are on very low HP. So the Nyx serves as kind of, you know, the invisible backup. Not even like an offensive invisibility rune, but it just helps them out a little bit. The pings are going out still, but the invis is going to wear out right now. And they do go for the stun. Are they going to initiate? TA is here. This is why they're going. Nyx Assassin, Spike Carapace is out, maybe a little bit too early. And that is it. Ah. Oh. Yeah, that wasn't as elegant as I hoped for Pain.
The problem was that Animage and Rubick were sort of stuck behind creeps, and if they start running forward, it sort of makes the gank attempt super obvious.
Yeah. Yes. All right, now we have a Soul Ring up on Darkseid. Have a quick check of the items. Oh, Lone Druid, there's that Hand of Midas, so his farm will get out of control relatively shortly here. Let's go over to the gold per minute. Top three farmed heroes so far are from 4FC, and it's all the important ones. Darkseer, Lone Druid, and Kunkka. The supports are fine without as much farm. We even have Darkseer jacking the farm from TA at the weak spot in mid. And he's rejoining the lane in mid as the creep wave arrives. So he's not missing on anything, just getting that extra gold. On bottom lane again, Blink Out, forced from Anti-Mage. So this not... I mean, he does survive, but then again, the time he needs to spend just running back and healing up is time not spent farming, and that's a win for 4FC.
The other thing that's significant is the level difference in this tri-lane. Nyx Assassin, almost level 4, which sort of matches the Shadow Demon. But if you look at Rubick, he is only level 2.
Oh, yeah.
Whereas you have Jakiro level 5 and Kunkka almost level 6.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, that's definitely going to be a problem later on in the game for sure. And also just 85 gold per minute for Rubick. That's about like the gold income you get just from the game itself. And Enigma on top, at least, he's on level 8, got an item flying out to him at the moment. It's just boots and wards. But at least he's on level 6, so Pain could go looking for these teamfights, and that could certainly give them the upper hand that they need, or this chance to get themselves back in the game. There we go, Black Hole used, Krilly.
Black Hole used.
Yeah, focus down, TA gets the last hit. A little bit too late, Ice Path comes through. The support from 4FC here, though, good reaction on the TPs. Now we have the focus onto Enigma, Disruption goes out, so he's in huge trouble. TA is here, though, the auto attacks go through. Now Shadow Demon also takes a fall, and Enigma also dead now for Pain. And that will be the end for this engagement so far. But good TP reaction for 4FC. Get themselves one more kill on Enigma, but they lose the Shadow Demon in the end.
I think that's a worthwhile trade anyways, because it means that... I mean, both teams invested resources there. It's not like one team got off scot-free. And Kunkka can easily handle his own lane against Animage at this point. You see him even wandering around the backside of creeps just to get that Tidebringer on Animage's face.
Yeah, there we go. Oh, this guy really controlling that lane right now, making Anti-Mage realize that there's nothing he can do against him one-on-one, but TA at least is here. And if Kunkka didn't see that, he did see it. He was on the way back, but the slow was there. Now comes the support from Shadow Demon. Now they're focusing him, though. He does the disruption, holds onto it quite patiently, and TA backs out. So good support from Shadow Demon being there at the right point in time. Otherwise, Kunkka would have been in huge trouble.
Overall, it's really, really good rotation and support by 4FC. Right after they're done their work in top, they know it's time to go back bottom and support this Kunkka because he's the most vulnerable hero at the point of the game.
Absolutely, 4-3 the kill score. We have TA completing up a Medallion of Courage, and that even before she goes for completed phase boots. And now they might want to make use of this Medallion in the middle lane onto this really tanky Lone Druid. In comes Nyx Assassin. He's on level 5, but he's smoked up. Where's that stun? Slow goes out. There goes the stun up the high ground. Yeah, Mana Burn, Malphus. Support TP is coming in, though. Who is it? It's Darkseer. Is he going to surge him out? Yes, he does do it, but there's a haste on TA. Yes, she's chasing, but it's not going to be successful. Gets pulled back in by the vacuum, and that is it for so far. And Rubick, in the meantime, went down. He died to Shadow Demon on bottom lane then, and we can see a tower trade developing, mid lane being pressured, but we have Spirit Bear with Ion Shell and the Darkseer here to fend this off as the Tier 1 on bottom drops. So another good trade for 4FC as they're able to defend the Tier 1 in mid and get the Tier 1 on bottom.
And now we see this Shadow Demon Jakiro combo and even Kunkka leading up the end of that train rotating just because they know that there's a lot of Pain heroes in mid trying to push that tower, so see if they can pick off a kill here.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh man, 4FC really going on the offensive right now. They know they have a huge advantage in terms of gold, in terms of experience. By the way, we're talking about this 4.5k gold and just below 2,000 experience advantage for 4FC. So now we have the rotation. We have four heroes in mid. We have Darkseer also now trying to join his teammates. But the tier 1 is going to go down, and they might continue pushing this and force a teamfight at the tier 2. That's the decision they need to make right now. No, they decide to go farm. We have Lone Druid now going up top. And he's sitting at 1,400 gold, so with that Midas 12 minutes in, he's already getting some good gold in, but he's still getting outfarmed by Kunkka, who's sitting at almost 400 gold per minute, which isn't bad since Kunkka's on the same team as Sin, and he's rotating down toward the bottom lane with the, it's again, the full tri lane. They're sticking together, and Rubick going to be a really easy target for them if they get that initial disruption out, and they don't.
You see Kunkka is going for a lot of smaller mid-game items, sort of designed to carry the tide until this lone druid can build up that radiance and start to push down towers really
again,
effectively.
Again, top lane now, TA, there she is, and there goes the Malphite, mana burn, and TA gets the last hit. So one thing that Pain is doing very diligently is focusing that lone druid, and the mid-gank failed, but before that they got a kill on him, and now they killed him again. So this is the second death on top, 62 last hits, and they're keeping him down, and now they're pushing the tier 1 on top, and they're going to get let go of this tier 2 on bottom. So Pain so far getting some good pickoffs and some good trades considering the position that they're in at the moment.
Yeah, they're at least getting everything that they can. I don't think they feel confident to fight in a 5v5 situation, so that means that picking off single heroes is what they should be doing, and as a result they get a tower. I don't think they could have defended bottom.
Yeah, absolutely. There's a Mechno up on Darkseer as well as Enigma. With these teamfights, items going to be very important, and I think we might even see a Roshan attempt relatively soon, provided Pain gets this space on the map, which they don't have so far. So if they get a good teamfight going for them, then they have these potential follow-up actions that they can just execute by heart, essentially, since this is the type of thing that you are looking for at the moment. You want to get these wins, you want to get these easy pickoffs, and then a Roshan to get yourself back into this game, essentially, but because at the moment they are pretty far behind, but it's not a lost game yet by any means. And Nyx Assassin now goes invisible, goes for the Vendetta, heads toward the middle lane. There's no true side. Shadow Demon hanging back, but there's two other heroes. We got Jakiro as well as Kunkka. And yeah, an assassin coming in. Gonna find somebody. TA's here as well. Oh, look at him melt. Good disruption used though, but he's gonna go down nonetheless. Ship goes through from Kunkka. No! Shadow Demon still alive. Now he only goes down after a lot of damage is done. Shadow Demon is here. Darkseer, rather, and it's one for one so far. Nyx Assassin did go down, and we have Enigma here as well, and the black hole is up, but they actually decide to back out for now.
Yeah, Shadow Demon did a really, really good job of staying alive for as long as he could, just buying his team enough time. Well, basically buying enough time for that big ship to land.
Yeah, and that went straight for Nyx Assassin. They got the kill on him, but I think Shadow Demon died. Yeah, he died before Nyx Assassin, but nonetheless, he made sure that he just stayed alive as long as possible and got that set up for the kill. And even a quick reaction to disable, to disrupt the TA, otherwise he would have been dead long ago. And now TA and Enigma heading toward the middle lane, pressuring the tier 1, and if we don't see any TP reaction, then it's going to go down. Here actually comes the Glyph, and the duration got buffed a few versions ago. And now comes the TP, Darkseer here as well, surges himself up there, and we have Shadow Demon waiting in the wings. This could be really bad for Pain. Where's the vacuum? Not coming just yet. Enigma, he does have the black hole. Pain, first one to drop, yes, TA goes down, but Enigma doesn't want to go for the black hole, and he still had mech and everything. That's why I was kind of confused.
Yeah, and Rubick was in the background, and he has Torrent, so that's a decent follow-up to
the
black hole.
Yeah, that's why I was so confused. I didn't think, you know, TA is relatively tanky as long as Refaction is up. As soon as the Refaction broke, he could have been there with the black hole and the mech. Like, mech first, go for the black hole. This would have been a good 3 to 4 seconds of disable. And then, of course, as you said, the Rubick, I didn't even see him right there, but with the Torrent, that would have been something. I mean, TA dishes out a crap load of damage, even just with phase boots at this stage of the game. She could have melted the supports in the black hole, I believe. But still, it's a type of types of decisions you need to make when you're in a really stressful situation. And I mean, mistakes happen. So if it was a mistake, then it's obviously understandable. But Pain need to make some big plays because we have 4FC now, whacking away at the big guy, and it doesn't... Yes, they're not even challenging this. Roshan going to go down to 4FC, and this will catapult their lead even further ahead. Right now, it's sitting at about 5,000 gold, and yeah, just below 3,000 experience disadvantage for Pain, and now it's just going to, you know, get way worse.
I don't even think Pain knew it was going to happen, because you see they're smoked in the top jungle now. They're going to go for this lone druid who just TP'd, though. He's got the Aegis.
Yeah, true that, absolutely. That would be a really strong pickoff if they were able to get him twice. Let's have a check of the items. We have so many TP scrolls on 4FC. No way they're going to kill him twice. You know, they might not... Yeah, I don't think they can even kill him once. Unless Enigma gets a really sick black hole off, but we have Krilly standing really good. In comes Nyx. First TP coming in. On Enigma, this is your time to get a really good black hole. Is it going to be first kill? Good disruption by Shadow Demon. Going to save the life of Lone Druid for the moment. Now all of Pain is backing out. We still have the mech up as well as the black hole Enigma. That's the item as well as the skill to watch out for. Vacuum in back on TA. Wall goes up by Darkseer. He's going to get focused though so far. Oh my goodness, down he goes. Killing spree actually on Kunkka right now. Darkseer down for 4FC and Rubick down for Pain. We have the chase now underway. TA trying to get down Jakiri. He turns around and goes for the ulti. Now we have TA under big pressure. Dodges the ice path. Good stun by Nyx. Buys her some time. And she heads herself up there with the regen rune. Now she can probably wait and start the ambush. But there's already a Shadow Blade up on Kunkka. TP goes out. X marks the spot.
Exit.
Yep, back so soon. TA might is in huge trouble. And she's certainly going to go down. Oh boy.
And Lone Druid made it out. So, the hero that they were going for, the Lone Druid, trying to prevent him from getting that relic, is just as close as he was when the fight started.
Yeah. Oh, man. But, again, that's why Shadow Demon is one of my favorite supports out there. The disruption is so versatile, and we saw it set up some clutch kills on bottom. The first bottom bottom was set up by a disruption. Then he saved the life of Lone Druid, and it also... kept Shadow Demon alive a few minutes before that. Disruption, such a good skill. Shadow Demon, such a boss support player. No wonder the Chinese really love that guy. And yeah, just great play by 4FC so far. And Pain, they are looking for the right pickoffs. But I mean, then again, Lone Druid had a really good game sense in the fact that he stood right underneath his tier 2 tower. And Pain was forced to dive him. And the support TPs were there. So everything going fine for 4FC so far. Items. As we saw, the Shadow Blade is up for Kunkka, the point booster now up on Darkseer. He's probably looking for an Aghanim Scepter or something along those lines. And on the Radiant side, we have Enigma looking for...
Oh, Black Hole. Mid lane.
Oh yeah, just used for Darkseer. Yeah, I think he's going to go down. Melt Strike from TA seals the deal. Thanks for pointing that out, man.
I was actually about to say that Enigma needs to use his Black Hole. It's been off cooldown for what seems like the entire game.
Yeah, absolutely. Is it going to be a deny? No, not quite there. And even a disruption onto Nyx Assassin right now. No follow-up Torrent, though. And Nyx Assassin used to go for Vendetta to get himself out of there. He's probably going to disrupt this. Oh, no. I was sure he would try and cancel the TP from Shadow Demon, but not there in time. Even an Ice Path right now just to piss him off a little bit more. And there's a Battle Fury on Anti-Mage right now. It's a 90-minute Battle Fury, and... Oh, boy. I mean, it's a big milestone for him, but for now he will need to spend at least 10 minutes farming to get these, to get a Manta up, to get all these items up. And the fact that Lone Druid didn't die right now, you know, results in his relic that he just bought up. So even though we have a Battle Fury up now on Anti-Mage, he can start farming and just do what an Anti-Mage does, 4FC's advantage in the game so far is of such a magnitude that the Battle Fury on Anti-Mage is certainly something that they can deal with.
Yeah, a lot of it will come down to how the next 5 to 10 minutes gets played out. Animage hasn't revealed the Battle Fury yet. He's only been in the jungle, so 4FC, as soon as they know it's there...
Again. Oh my goodness, Lone Druid, he's getting focused once more. Good chain stunning, good chain nuking even. But again, the disruption! I thought he was dead! It was the disruption again from Shadow Demon. The ulti now used on Rubick. He melts, and the Ice Path Macro Pyre flies through as well. And all Pain need to back out. TP attempted by Enigma. It's going to be successful, and now they're chasing after the invisible Nyx Assassin. Holy crap, again, Pain investing so many resources to try and get a kill onto Lone Druid. It's just not successful. TA even running away right now. What's happening with Nyx Assassin? He TPs out. Will TA be fine? That's the big question. There's a vacuum up on Darkseer. Pulls her all the way back. Again, the disruption. And this is going to be a dead TA. Good ice path. Great play by 4FC.
Another thing that we should note is that Shadow Demon has picked up that gem. So Nyx Assassin no longer as big of a threat. And TA doesn't have that free hide. I mean, it's not really an escape, but... Can't just use meld to buy herself some time.
Absolutely. There's still that relic on Spirit Bear. What's going on in middle lane, man? The black hole is still off cooldown. That's the thing. If it's not on level 3, then the cooldown is just almost unbearably long. And, man, Pain is... Oh, I don't even know what to... I mean, Payne is doing some really good decisions when looking for the most important hero, because in the end it will come down to the battle of Anti-Mage versus Lone Druid. The age-old Dota duel has always been, ever since the Dota 1 days, Anti-Mage versus Lone Druid. And they are focusing the right target, but the team play from 4FC has been almost impeccable the whole game. Shadow Demon was there for a second time right now there with a clutch disruption, which basically paved the way for a good teamfight turnaround for 4FC, and we can see this on the gold graph right now. It's been steadily rising in favor of 4FC, and even you can see all the teamfights now taking place on the experience graph. Some very impressive play from 4Friends and Krilly so far.
Yeah, one thing that I'd also like to say is that any mage needs to spend these next couple minutes finding as much farm as he can, yes, but Payne needs to let Animage do that. So that means that you need to sort of protect your own jungle where Animage is going to want to farm, even protecting the enemy jungle as we see right now, even the Rubik's just sort of hanging around near the Animage just to make sure that he's safe, because basically that's what they're relying on, is this Animage needs to become bigger than that Lone Druid, and in order to do that, he needs to be safe.
Absolutely. And Kunkka, Shadowblade, Demon Edge up on him, so he's probably looking for that big crit. TA is going straight for that BKB, not even a blink attempted so far. How much gold does she have? The recipe for the BKB is sitting in the stash. 1,100 gold is what she needs. Then she has that magic immunity up that she really needs in these team fights. Yasha on Anti-Mage, but it's still not nearly as enough for him to carry this team to victory, because he's got such a
Enigma
big...
Enigma going down.
Oh, goodness.
Smoke gank there by 4FC. Enigma's also getting close to a Black King bar, about 600 away. It was 300, now 600 away.
Yeah, that's pretty important there. The warding from 4FC also quite, well, relatively aggressive. It's the Rune Spot slash the Roshan pit. Roshan will be up in 2.5 to 3 minutes. And yes, these are the important wards right here. Up on this little hill there, or on this little mountain, is where both teams are going to be wanting to have vision. And we have Rubik place, basically dedicating an Observer and a Sentry Ward to keep that position. And with that black hole down from Enigma, we have 4FC mounting a push in the Tier 2 in mid, and it's going to be successful as well. Lastly goes to Darkseer, and the question is if they are going to stop. I think they should. They should probably just use the advantage they have on the map to keep on farming and get further ahead. All outer towers are now down for Payne, and everything is looking good for 4FC. They just don't... The only thing they can do right now to contribute to not winning this game is overextending.
Yeah, Animage is actually doing a really good job being where 4FC is not. I mean, he looks to be running in a little bit of trouble here. Doesn't quite get X'd there by the Kunkka. That was almost an X.
Oh, yes. And Payne, you can see them now walking across the map a little bit, you know, like headless chicken. They're not sure what they need to do. And it's a tough call to make, man. If you were a captain of Payne, what would you tell your team to do right now? You're facing a Lone Druid that's getting slowly out of control, and you do have a TA that does some really strong damage, and all you need is that good team fight with a good black hole, and your carry is just kind of whacking away. On top lane, Kunkka, do they have anything to reveal him off, though? That's a big question. I don't think so.
That's okay, he just used his Shadow Blade, which means that it's going to be he's going to be revealed soon.
Yeah. Out he comes. And he gets away for now. And we have all of 4FC in a rotating up. They are under the cover of smoke. Darkseer level 13. Agdam Scepter completed. So is the mech. Shadow Demon just tanking up a little bit. And they're now looking for it. And all of Payne are now backing out. This is very valuable time wasted. But we have Anti-Mage at least on bottom farming away. He almost has Manta Style. So, yeah, with a Manta Style at least he will have something more to offer for his team in the team fights. But he will need one more big item, in my opinion. Perhaps like a BKB so he can stand and fight a little bit longer. And that's the big question you always have to ask yourself as a carry. Do I need to go for that BKB or one extra damage item? For now, I think with all the disables 4FC has, he needs to be able to just stand there and team fight. A Manta by itself is not going to be enough to help him in that regard.
Yeah, if I'm Payne at this point, I sort of want to get any mage as big as I can so that you can contest Roshan when it comes up. It's back up almost right now.
Yeah, here we go. And even we have Krilly on the Lone Druid. Having his main hero sieging that tier 3 as well. Now he's coming back, and now this is more usual. You always have that Spirit Bear committed toward the siege and not your main hero, really. And oh, down here we have Nyx Assassin. What a good pickoff for 4FC. Very important. There's probably no buyback on Nyx Assassin. So now they can just continue pushing. One hero is down. It's a 4v5 situation in a game which favors them nonetheless. So you can see them just, you know, calm, going up the high ground, fighting this. Enigma does have the BKB, though. So he's really looking for it right now. And 4FC now know he does have a BKB. He's getting 4 staffed in, goes to the BKB, Black Hole. And an even better vacuum right now was actually used by Rubik, who stole it. Ship comes in from Kunkka. 2 heroes down for Pain still. It's Nyx Assassin and Rubik also down. The BKB is still up. We have a BKB on TA as well. And no heroes die for 4FC. What the hell happened there? Tier 3 is down, and 4FC is still sieging. I hear an X marks the spot on TA. She throws out a trap. Shadow Demon is on low HP, and they are forced to walk through the wall, but Animage committing to Shadow Demon, who gets surged in turn. And Nyx Assassin also here. Stun goes out onto Kunkka. He does have the Shadow Blade, but no mana for it. Slow goes out from TA. Good Ice Path also used by Jakiro. Malphus goes out onto Darkseer. Good Disruption once more. TA turns around. Is she going to fight this? That's, oh my goodness! Kunkka just melts TA as well as Enigma. And Nyx Assassin forced to back out, and he goes down to the Shadow Poison. No, it was another hit from Kunkka.
Animage looking to pick off some kills here, though.
Yeah, well, Jakiro is down and so is Shadow Demon, but that was some pretty big plays there by Kunkka, some big hits.
Well, what's good for Pain there is that Animage didn't die, and they didn't lose their racks. So overall, I mean, you lose heroes, yes, but you're not out of it yet.
Yeah, absolutely. That they didn't lose their racks, that's really good for Pain. The teamfight really didn't favor them in a way, and they lost a tier 3, but yeah, if you look at it from the bright side, they certainly are still in the game, since they have an anti-mage with the Battle of Fury and a Manta-style 2.1k gold, 2.2. He's farming like crazy. The gold per minute is coming up there, so he will overtake Kunkka slowly but relatively shortly. And Roshan's back up, so 4FC are again committing a little bit of time to it, and perhaps Pain want to challenge this, but I'm not so sure. Anti-mage right now seems content to just keep on farming.
I don't know if they can challenge it with Enigma Black Hole not being up. It's a risky maneuver to try and challenge Roshan, especially when you're not confident.
Yeah, and no Black Hole. No Black Hole Enigma. It was a good 4-staff, though, onto Enigma. Who got that? Who got that 4-staff off, anyways? I think even... Who has a 4-staff? It's Jakiro, so it's not even anybody on Pain's side that 4-staffed Enigma into the best position for the Black Hole. It was actually Jakiro that 4-staffed the Enigma. So they wanted to get him out of position, but why would you 4-staff Enigma if you know he's got a BKB?
I don't know.
And then you had the vacuum stolen by Rubik, and he just kind of vacuumed everybody into the Black Hole. But still, the follow-up damage from Pain just wasn't there. That was, you know, some big question marks there. I might need to look at this on the...
Yeah. Well, even after that happened, like, it's not like 4FC lost any heroes.
Yeah, they didn't lose anyone. Like, after that, you know, just in that post-climax team fight is what gave Animage the chance to kind of chase after Jakiro and Shadow Demon to pick those two off, but...
Animage may take a tower here. He's definitely putting a lot of pressure on it.
Yeah, certainly. That's actually a crap load of damage.
1,300 damage on a tower.
Yeah. That's very good. So Pain, not out of it yet. They have Enigma. I mean, a Black Hole is the teamfight ultimate that you want to have, maybe apart from Ravage, but still it goes through BKB even. So it's probably the best ultimate they can ask for, especially with an anti-mage who will just get a crap load of damage. His attack speed already very, very high. It will splash due to the Battle Fury. He's got the mana break as well and the AoE ultimate. So far, if Pain are able to, you know, they have the best lineup they can ask for almost for a comeback. I mean, simply by virtue of TA, Enigma, and Anti-Mage. And by now, Anti-Mage is sitting at 3.7k gold, and he's just, yeah, this creep wave away from completing up a BKB, if that's actually what he chose to go for.
Yeah, for TA. Now I expect him to go for buyback. TA, I don't know if they know TA is there, but they have a gem.
Yeah.
Oh, they spotted her.
She's going to have to go for BKB TP. There we go.
Entangle? Oh, no entangle.
Oh man, and Anti-Mage bottom lane again pressuring. He's split pushing them like crazy. And if they do commit to these racks, do they have Glyph? They don't have a Glyph. There we go. He's going to get a tier 3. Is this going to be a Raksh trade even? Because Anti-Mage, if there's no defense, Anti-Mage is going to go for this. The only thing that Payne needs to watch out for is not to die on top. Don't commit heroes for that. Anti-Mage on bottom. We have Kunkka here. He's going to go for the big crit. Anti-Mage has to retreat. And he's even TPing right now. BKB Black Hole used by Enigma once more. Stun goes out again from Nyx Assassin. TA whacking away like crazy. Darkseer the first one to drop. Macro Pyre goes out as well. The wall from Darkseer also down. Anti-Mage is here. I hear an ultimate, but it didn't really do as much as I thought. Anti-Mage
he ultimated
after
an illusion.
Oh, good job. Now, oh, TP cancelled by Jakiro. We still have Lone Druid in the mix. And now Anti-Mage switched target onto him. And he might actually be in trouble right now. I don't think he can fight this unless he gets a really good entangle onto him. But he's blinking away and chasing the Lone Druid. There's the entangle. And Anti-Mage will need to get out of here.
Curly's got Aegis, though.
There. Yes, he does have the Aegis. Still. Oh, is he going to go down? Yes, but the bear still focusing him down. Down goes Anti-Mage. Darkseer gets killed. Nyx Assassin turn. Now Lone Druid comes back. Ice Path goes on to TA. The gem vision is there. Down she goes. Four heroes down for Pain. And this leaves only Rubick to defend.
Yeah, I think that was a poor decision to tunnel vision the Lone Druid.
Oh, man.
Wow, Anti-Mage had a lot of money, though, because he bought back and still almost has a Black King bar.
The buyback is actually pretty cheap for Anti-Mage at this point, I think. Yeah, just sitting at 1,100. So, yeah, he had like 4.2, 4.3k gold. And he's going for a heart. That's also a good choice, I think. Either BKB or just tank up like crazy. Heart also good choice. But the Lone Druid Bear is going to be really messing him up. And we saw that in just this teamfight. Just one-on-one, Anti-Mage would have really easily taken out the Lone Druid. But just that really tanky Bear with the Entangle passive was enough to take care of Anti-Mage, even though Lone Druid had to back out. Now the mid-tier 3 being attempted. Slow goes up from TA, but that's not going to phase 4FC whatsoever. Darkseer is here with the Aghanim Scepter ready. The ulti is off cooldown. Good torrent by Kunkka. Are they going to go for this Ice Path? Anti-Mage goes in. Kunkka immediately gets a double kill. Two heroes down. What happened there? Huge crit. Boat flies through. Not going to miss on the Rubick. He also drops.
Oh, another crit.
Oh, big crit by Kunkka here. And Anti-Mage forced back, even with that Messerschmitt's Reaver, he's not able to just stand that teamfight. The wall from Darkseer also too strong, and they're just rotating down toward the bottom tier 3 to finish off this game. These teamfights happen so fast, holy crap.
Yeah, that was the Kunkka with a billion damage getting a crit.
Yeah. Darkseer actually went down, the Anti-Mage has been here. Dual Breath goes out, Anti-Mage blinks himself away. Holy cow. So, did Kunkka crit twice?
I think he had two big whacks, both Tidebringer, both crit.
Oh, man. Rubick gets 4 staff back in.
Oh, there's another crit.
Holy cow. For how much does he crit? I haven't spotted it yet. TA getting focused as well. BKB, but Kunkka don't care. Just whacks right through that magic immunity. At least they might get a Darkseer. No, there's a good Ice Path again. The Macro Pyre flies through. Anti-Mage has a Blink after him. Black Hole right now used by Pain. China on Enigma. And this might actually be a kill onto Jakiro, who forced themselves away. And nothing to follow up since the Ancient is going down. 4FC takes the win versus Pain. 28-12, 35 minutes into the game. Ham, man, what happened there?
Well, we were talking about how this fight was brewing between Anti-Mage and Lone Druid, and then suddenly Kunkka appears on the screen, gets one crit, and that ends the game.
Yeah, and also, yeah, absolutely. That was for the later stages of the game. Then 4FC played a really strong tri-lane, and was kind of unusual. The Kunkka Jakiro Shadow Demon worked out quite well simply by virtue of that disruption setup. And yeah, it was a great game to watch. Guys, don't go anywhere. We have MTW coming up next. I don't even know when it's going to be. I think it's going to be in about 20 minutes to half an hour. I will check and let you know afterwards. For now, this has been it. The VOD recording will stop. Stay tuned, though. I will see you guys in just a few moments.
I said good day, sir!